Good morning, student. Myself Melissa Nathia, and today we start with our topic displacement method. And in this method, we start our first method, Macaulay's method. Okay. In previous lecture, I will explain you different type of method, and here we start with our first method, that is Macaulay's method. Now, what is the use of this Macaulay's method? Macaulay's method is used to find out slope and deflection for different type of beam. Next, which point should we take care while using Macaulay's method? Here we study different type of method. Each and every method has some rule. So that first of all, we understand which point we should take care while we calculating the example with Macaulay's method. First, always take origin on extreme left of the beam. Okay. Second point. At left hand side, our clockwise moment is positive and anticlockwise moment is negative. Third point, for any term when x minus a less than 0, it means we have to consider this quantity x minus a less than 0, that means it is negative term. Next, if quantity x minus a should be integrated, this like x minus a square by 2. In maths, we familiar with x minus a integration x square by 2. Minus a is equal to minus ax, but in integration we solve with Macaulay's method, we have to integrate all term x minus a square by 2. Now the next one, constant c1 and c2 add in first term. Okay, this constant I will explain you at the time of calculation. Next, quantity x minus a written as x minus a raised to 0 when distance multiply with distance. Okay guys, if moment is given on span and the term x minus a is given, then we have to return as x minus a raised to 0, particular in case of moment. Next, step for Macaulay's method. Again, here when we solve the example with Macaulay's method, we have to follow this step. If any type of beam, maybe possible this beam is cantilever, overhanging or simply supported. First step of beam is find out support reaction. Okay, suppose first point is A and last point is B, then our main first step is find out support reaction, that is RA and RB. We should write V and VB also. Now take section XX at distance X from left support in last part of the beam. That means here we already learned that origin point is considered as a left end and our section will be at right hand side. That means at that point we have to consider section XX. Second, take moment of all forces about section axis. Okay, now our section is right hand side, that means all given number of forces are given on left hand side. In that, reaction load are given and we have to take moment of all given number of forces and also our support reaction about x axis. Okay, that will be on right hand side. Next, by using separate the moment of each force compartment line, that means here we separate the term with compartment line, it's not necessary, but we should try to take it. Next, use the differential equation of beam that we already proved, EI d square by dx were is equal to minus m. Next, integration above equation, while integrating keep constant of integration generally in first complementary only. Oh, that means when we integrate the term of differential equation, that is our equation of slope, in this first equation we add constant c1 and again integrate the term, and in this time again we add our constant c2. Okay, and that is the equation of deflection. Then find out value of constant c1 c2 applying the boundary condition, and finally find out slope and deflection that given on particular point on data. Now one by one we solve the first example of our Macaulay's method. Okay, here I take a data and figure is given in data. A beam of span 4 meters simply supported at end and loaded as shown in figure. Using Macaulay's method, determine the slope at A and deflection under the point C. And this EI, this already explained you, EI is our flexure rigidity, 2 into 10 raised to 3 kilonewton per meter square. Kilonewton meter square. Next, here the beam is given. Okay, and in this beam we can say that first point load is given, and this point load is 10 kilonewton And in second case, UDL is given, that is 5 kilonewton per meter according to our Michaelis method. First, find out support reaction. Now, always we remember that support reaction is find out with respect to any reference point. So, here I take A point as a reference. So, write down taking moment about A. Our first step is taking moment about A. About A, and in this moment we compare anti-clockwise moment with clockwise moment. Okay, suppose we remember that this is our support this point is our support reaction RB. Okay, now with respect to RB, A point rotate anti-clockwise, write down on left hand side RB into distance 4 meter, that is equal to, now one by one taking the load, 10 kilonewton is rotate with respect to clockwise direction up to this A point, distance is 1 meter. Plus second, UDL is given, moment of UDL is equal to load into distance 5 into 2, and from A point 2 plus 2 by 2. Okay, now our support reaction RB is equal to, when we solve this we get support reaction RB is equal to 10 kilonewton. Now find out RA. RA is equal to total vertical load minus RB. Now what is total vertical load? That is 10 plus UDL is given 5 into 2 minus, we find out support reaction, that is 20 minus 10 is equal to 10 kilonewton. That is the first of Michaelis method. Now mention here support A, here we find out the value of, that is 10 kilonewton. Now according to rule of Michaelis method, we have to consider this distance as a x and take section xx at right hand side. Now next step, make a equation of moment. Okay, now write here what is the equation of moment. M is equal to first 10 kilonewton rotate clockwise, at clockwise left hand side positive 10 into x, then minus 10 kilonewton load, this point load is rotated anti-clockwise 10, and x minus 1 left hand side, the distance is 1 meter, then again go, next is point UDL given, moment of UDL is load into distance and distance by 2, that is x, and left hand side the distance keep, that is minus 2, x minus 2 and x minus 2 by 2. Okay, now simplify this, 10 x minus, this is our point load, 10 x minus 1 and minus 5 by 2 x minus 2 square. Next, what is the differential equation? Right here, our differential equation is equal to EI d square y dx square is equal to minus m. Simply, we change the sign of this equation. Again, right here, EI d square y dx square is equal to minus, means change the sign. Minus 10x, then plus 10 x minus 1 and plus 5 by 2 x minus 2 square. Okay, now next, here next step, we integrate the given term in. Okay, first again we write here what is our equation of EI, that is d square y dx square is equal to first 10x, then minus 10x minus 1, then minus 5x minus 2 square by 2. Now first integrate this term according to our rule of Michaelis method, integrate it. Okay, now EI, integration of d square by dx square is equal to dy by dx is equal to, and right here 10, and what is the integration x? X square by 2, and rule of Michaelis method, add first constant c1, then minus 10, and quantity x minus a, integrate as x minus a square by 2, that means square by 2, minus 5 by 2 constant, and integration of this term, x minus 2 raised to cube by 3. This is our first equation of slope right here. Now, according to rule of Michaelis method, again integrate it. Okay, again integrate above term. Now, EI and integration of dy by dx is equal to y. Then, 10 by 2, that is 5, x cube by 3, and integration of this constant c1x plus, again add constant c2 in first term. Here, okay, this will be minus x minus 1 cube by 3, and this is minus 3 to the 6, minus 5 by 6, and right here x minus 2 raised to 4 by 4, and this is the equation of deflection. Okay, here this is the equation of deflection. In next step, apply boundary condition right here. Apply boundary condition. Okay, now most important thing that is, remember, boundary condition are apply always and always support. Okay, suppose here our beam is given like this way, that means this is our first support and this is our second support, and load is given here, and this load is 10 kilonewton, and up to this our UDL is given. Okay, this point is A and this point is B. This is 1 meter, 1 meter, and 2 meter. That means boundary condition apply this A point and this B point. Okay, now when we start with this A point, our x distance is equal to 0, and at this starting point our y distance is also 0. Now check it. In first equation, slope, that is E divided by dx, and second y, where is the value of E and y both are present? That is equation number 2. Write it, equation number 2. Okay, and put this value in equation number 2. Y is equal to 0, here x is equal to 0, then x is equal to 0, c1 constant 0, then in this term 0 minus 1, that is x minus a less than 0, cancel this term, x minus 2, 0 minus 2, negative term cancel. That means simply in this equation we get c2 is equal to 0. Blindly we take always c2 is equal to 0. Now next boundary condition, we take next support. Look at this, this beam AB. Okay, this is our A point and this is our B point. At A point, B point, x is equal to 4. Right here x is equal to 4 meter at second support, and same point y is equal to 0. Now again put this value in equation number 2, that means this first. Now one by one, e I y, that means first term is 0, second term 5 by 3, and x is equal to 4 cube. Second c1 into distance 4 meter, and constant c2 is equal to 0, that we already find out. Then minus 5 by 3 and x is equal to 4 minus 1 is equal to cube. Second, minus 5 by 6 and 4 minus 2 raised to 4 by 4. Okay, when we simplify this term, we get c1 is equal to 14.58. okay, here we get our first constant c1, that is 14.58. okay, in next we find out slope and deflection. Now again, to find out slope and deflection, that is particular point, okay, that means this point. Okay, here I draw again this beam. Our beam is like this. This is our first point and this is our second point, and this point is subjected with UDL. Now next, this is A point and this is P point. Okay, and this one is our point load is given here, 10 kilonewton. and we find out our constant C1 is equal to 14.58. Now, first of all, find out slope at A. In data, we mentioned that find out slope at A. Okay. Now, right here, our first point is equal to find slope at A. That means at A point, this is the starting point, at slope at A, distance x is equal to 0. Now, what is the equation of dy by dx? Dy by dx is equal to, write down the equation of dy by dx, that is minus 5x square plus c1 plus 5x minus 1 square, then plus divide 0.833 x minus 2 raised to cube. Now here we put x is equal to 0, that means our first term is 0, and the value of already we find out, that is 14.58 plus 5 again 0 minus 1 square, then 0.833 and 0 minus 2 raised to cube. This is the x minus a less than 0, that means cancel this term. This term is cancelled and this term is cancelled. Ultimate dy by dx is equal to slope at A. We can write theta A also, and our answer 14.58 given and divide by EI. Now 14.58 and value of EI is given, and that is 2 into 10 raised to 3, and after simplifying we get 0.000729 radian. Okay, and this is plus, so we take clockwise. This is our first answer for slope at A. Now second, find out deflection at C. Okay, right here, deflection at C point, and at C point our distance x is equal to 2 meters. Now what is the equation of deflection? EIY is equal to minus 5 by 3 x cube plus our constant C1 14.58 x, then plus 5 by 3 x minus 1 raised to cube plus 0.833 x minus 2 raised to 4 by 4. Now put the value of x is equal to 2, and after putting this value we have to get EIY is equal to 17.5. okay, this is our simplification. Now to find out y is equal to 17.5 divided by EI, and what is the value of EI? 17.5 2 into 10 raised to 3, that is equal to, our answer is equal to 8.75 mm, and this is plus in down direction. Okay, here we complete the example of slope and deflection by Michaelis method, and here I consider simple supported beam with point load and UDL. In next session we solve the example again Michaelis method, but we consider moment. Okay.